The Star of the Week。 さて今週のスターオブザウィークは、この方たちをスタジオにゲストとして迎えております。デフレパードの主要メンバーであります。はい、
welcome。 How about introducing yourself?
Right. Yeah, I'm Phil Collin.
And I'm Joe Elliott. Hello.
Welcome. They keep you very busy here, right?
Yeah, yeah. Once we just finished a tour and that was really busy.
Oh yeah. This is your first visit?
This is my first visit, but Phil's second.
Yeah, I came here about 3 years ago with a band called Girl.
Uh-huh, yeah, that's right. Tell us about Def Leppard. Let's start with, was it in 70?
78 when we first got together.
When you were...
knee high to a grasshopper, as they say in England. Yeah, we were all 16, 17, 18 years old, yeah. And...
In Sheffield.
Yeah, in Sheffield, England, which is about 160 miles north of London.
Mm.
And we were just toying with the idea of trying to get a band together, because we weren't actually a band to start with. We were just five people that at least two of the five knew somebody else in the band. You know?
Right.
And it was just an idea, let's do it for fun rather than going out and just causing trouble or you know, being hooligans or whatever.
Yeah.
So we just decided we'd try and have a go at getting a band together, and the five of us came together over a period of about 8 weeks, and it just clicked. Just like that. It was amazing.
Do they have places where you can perform in Sheffield then?
Yeah, there is, but we were far from the performing stage when we first got together. We spent 6 or 7 months just writing and rehearsing songs before we even attempted to play live. We didn't actually want to do any gigs until we were good and had a lot of songs. We always had the attitude of let's do it properly if we are going to do it. So we ended up on our first concert, the first gig we ever did, which was at a school in Sheffield.
Yeah.
We got paid £5 for
it. £5?
And we added an hour's worth of material that we'd written ourselves. It was completely original.
Did you knock the door as many record companies? Or?
Well, what happened originally, we weren't getting any help from anybody. But when we did eventually get gigs, they were like one a month, because nobody wanted to book a hard rock band because the synthesizer stuff was just coming out and they were more interested in that. So we could never get concerts very often. So we decided, well, if nobody else will help us, we'll do it ourselves. And we made a record. We went into a recording studio, cut 3 songs in about 10 hours. And it turned out quite well. I don't know why.
That's from your pocket money, right?
Yeah, we borrowed it off my parents and we stole things and, you know, like usual rock and roll story. We did it, and for some reason it came out real well. It shouldn't have done, because it was the first time we'd ever seen a recording studio, never mind being in one. Somebody up there was watching over us, I think. Thank you very much. And it turned out really well. We had 1,000 singles pressed. We sent them around radio stations, music papers, and it got real good, strong reviews, and it indirectly led to the record deal about 8 months later with
Oliver. And took you 3 years to Pyromania.
Yeah.
3 years. That's getting pretty close to 2 million.
Nearly four and a half.
In America?
Yeah.
It's 2 million copies. Four and a half.
I mean, this is
great, isn't it?
This is great. I mean,
yeah, it took us by... We are still as shocked as you were then.
Okay, let's get into a very popular song, at the same time, very popular video. Do you sell video of this photograph?
No, we don't sell it. No, we give
that's
it away.
Promotion.
Yeah. No. Television only.
Okay. Photograph.
Thank you.
Fun working for video.
Yeah, it's very tiring.
Oh yeah,
but it is a lot of fun.
Yeah, it can take up like all day just doing it. But,
yeah, but it does. That's part of the fun, right?
You do
10 takes and 9 of them are wrong. After a while, they become hilarious. You know, that's why they take a long time to do. It takes you 24 hours to do a 3-minute video.
Right.
You've got to make it look as though it's all just in the 3 minutes.
Right. You perform a lot. Like this year, how many concerts so far?
So, well, when we finished, we've got a European tour to do just after we leave Japan. And when we finish that, it'll be about 175, 180 this year.
Mm-hmm. So is that exhausting or...?
Yeah, it can be, but we have learned over the years to pace ourselves, so the last concert is as easy as the first. I mean, they're all difficult, they're all hard, but it's like we won't drop dead after the first 40 or 50. But, you know, we don't spend all night drinking and things. We try and look after ourselves. I mean, we do go for the old boot. You know, we do hit the belly.
It has been known.
Yes, it has been known
to
empty a few bottles of vodka, but it's like we don't do it every night. You can't physically do that and expect to be as good as you're supposed to. You know, there's a lot of people, wherever you are, whether it be America, Japan or England, that paid good money to come and see you on stage. And it's your duty, really, to go on stage totally in control of what you're doing, because nobody wants to see some idiot lead singer falling down because he's had too much to drink, you know. I mean, when we do drink, we never drink before we go on stage, it's always afterwards.
Okay, how about Fooling, the latest video, right?
What? This is it. This is Fooling.
By Def Leppard?
Yes. Yeah, sort of. Because we've been so long on tour that we're just going to spend home with our parents at Christmas. Mm. And then we start working again, start writing the new album.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We start about January to write it, but I don't think we'll be recording it before about April. And God knows how long it'll take. So we like to take our time and mess around in the studio.
I mean, it's worth taking your time. I mean, when
you go
like 4 or 5 million.
Really, yeah.
Are you living in London or?
I'm kind of homeless at the moment. I'm more like a gypsy than anything else. I don't know. I was living in London before we came on tour, but I don't live anywhere now, so I don't know where the hell I'm going to live when I get back.
Mm. Same with all of us, really. We was all living at a certain place, but it was so long ago.
Wherever you have to pay tax, I mean, that's where you belong, right?
We don't want to pay tax, so we're going to live in the ocean.
Yeah, wherever we don't have to pay tax, that's where we belong.
Buy a boat and park it 12 miles offshore. And then let them argue who wants the money.
Okay, thank you for dropping.
Right, thanks.
Pleasure.